You got a microwave, haven't you?
Huh?
You got a microwave, haven't you?
Ask him how often he cooks. He's meant to cook one night a week.
No. What's the best way to start this?
Probably just like that.
Thanks again for all the support on the last video. Thankfully, Tim's let us into his house. So,
Over again.
And we're going to go through what he has to eat or what his kind of university meal is. And we've got some questions that you guys asked last time. I'm going to go through them now while he prepares the food.
Salmon with pesto. And I normally do it with some green beans, but I forgot to buy any, so it's just going
to
be salmon.
He didn't tell us to buy any, but yeah, it was our fault really, wasn't it?
And then I normally have it with mash, but I've already had my dinner and I can't.
The first one is from Shabby. It says, to Clarke, is cutting body fat whilst getting stronger and faster feasible? If so, what would be the best method?
Yes, is the short answer.
Because I always think like, when you want to turn stuff to muscle, you have to like put on the fat first, so you have to like eat more.
Yeah, I see what you mean, but it doesn't strictly work like that. In terms of a practical thing for this, if you're trying to lose weight but you still need to perform in training,
yeah,
obviously you need carbohydrates to perform the training session properly.
Okay.
If you're trying to lose weight, you might want to slightly lower carbohydrate, and that would just naturally lower calories, but then make sure you're eating enough carbohydrate around the session.
If you're rowing, say like we do at Brookes, we have a morning session and an afternoon session. What's the best thing to eat in between? Say we've got like a 2 hour break or an hour and a half break. What's the best thing to eat?
So just something with enough carbohydrate. You want a bit of protein in there as well. And if you can get some veg, that's fine. That'd be really useful. And probably just fruit, like bananas are pretty useful for it.
Let's move on to now race day.
For a rowing race, you need carbohydrate.
Yeah.
So yeah, like bread, pasta, rice, potatoes, anything like that is that has to be the basis of what's going to fuel you for the race. So that can start the night before. If you really struggle to eat on the day of the race, make sure you get a proper meal,
a big plate
of pasta or something the night before. And then you actually want to eat a little bit less of sort of protein and fat because it takes longer to digest. Pre-race lunch. It might be something that you have to take with you, so again, it might be sandwiches or...
What kind of sandwich is it?
My favourite sandwich. Yeah. Oh, mate, we're getting to this.
Yeah.
Probably cheese and pickle, mate.
Really?
Yeah. I've had cheese and pickle sandwiches before Henley races before.
Really? Before your Henley final against Norris.
I can't remember what happened before that. Yeah. Oh, really?
For that, do you reckon that's why he lost?
But I think that's something that a lot of people who kind of like watch this wanted to know.
I basically thought we were going to come through them because we were moving so quickly. So we finished and I was like, that was my fourth Henley final. So I was like, and I'd never won. So I was like, my loss is just like, I was like, it's happened again. But oh shit, I just want to go back to the start and do it again. Because at the end of a race, you're like completely knackered. You have no idea what was going on. Some people were like, we got into the landing stage, I didn't even know what had happened.
Yeah.
Our coach was like, right, we're going to go. Got to go over. I've got a meeting now. Go and stand outside the boat. Our one coach had already gone.
Oh, okay.
And then our other coach was like, go over.
Also, Boris is already in there. And then...
I don't think Boris was in the meeting.
That's a joke, that's
right. Yeah, and then they obviously announced it. It was just a bit of a weird.
Yeah.
It was like the weirdest day. It was just a completely mixed emotions. Because I think a lot of us are like, imagine if we were. The narrowest boat, and that happened to us.
Yeah.
Raced a really close race. It was a very entertaining race. All we did was race the race, and we're not really sure how to feel about it because of everything that happened afterwards.
Did you speak to any of them after the race? Did you like shake hands or anything, or was it quite bitter?
I was like chatting to them in the boat tents.
Yeah,
because I didn't want like any animosity between the crew. And then they were just like, what? they just were like, we don't understand like what's going on. And I was like, I don't either. I think we spoke to them a bit in town as well. Like, they're all like,
so our next question is from someone I live with, Ollie Ayers. He says, can you ask Tim to talk about your experience as a runner and what was the hardest thing you found as a university athlete and how you combated that to be successful? Semi-successful.
I basically went to Newcastle Uni because I watched them win Henley and I liked the look of the kit.
Yeah.
And I originally was doing chemistry, but it turns out I was really bad at chemistry. So I basically dropped out like, at the end of my second year and restarted on nutrition. Put it as much effort into your course as you do into your rowing, and you can do well at both. They do complement each other, so it's not one or the other, basically.
Do you have any regrets from your university life?
Yeah, I really wish that I'd won Henley with Newcastle, but at the end of it. And we lost the final of the plate by 3 feet.
Who did you lose to then?
We lost to Cal Berkley.
There too.
Yeah. Actually, yeah, beat Browns 1-1. We got silver IRA. And then the last from Newcastle 1-1.
Here's another one. Do you recommend protein powder or protein through natural food sources?
I personally much prefer milk.
Yeah, so you don't take any protein shakes or?
I do every now and again, but only when like milk wouldn't be feasible, basically. There are very few supplements that you can get any benefit from.
Keeping your weight up, what about creatine?
Yeah, no, creatine definitely has its uses. It's still a very small part of the jigsaw.
So you address the bigger issues first?
Yeah, if you're training really hard, and sleeping as much as you can,
eating,
and getting your diet right,
yeah,
then you're gonna get better at running. And if you're going out and piss all the time, not sleeping much, eating bacon sandwiches for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and taking creatine, then
it's not much point.
Great for them. I think look at the more important things first.
You talk about going out and piss.
Yeah, I think the main point is that a lot of like beer and generally a lot, even like if you go out and have like VKs or whatever, I don't know where you go, like they are packed full of sugar. So if you're conscious of putting on weight,
and stay away from VKs.
Stay away from the VKs, yeah.
It's £5 for £10, mate. On a Wednesday night, it's quite a good offer.
Put in the fingers.
So you just finished coming back from your first senior World Cup. Can you tell us a little bit about your experiences and what it was like on a race out there?
It was all quite stressful over the trials period. Then we had like a little bit of selection and then managed to get into the end of the first World Cup. So yeah, that was just like, that's what I've been training for all season. So that, like, it was just an awesome experience. Especially because there were four Newcastle guys all in the same age.
I've got one more thing I want to ask you about, like, if you had to choose your top eight of guys you rode with, obviously you'd be in it, but who would they be?
Is it just like good lads? Or?
No, because obviously I'd be stroking that eight.
I'll probably miss people out here.
Tom must be on there, surely.
Tom, definitely. George Rossiter. I've been in some really good races with George, he's a great racer. Sam Arnott. I think these guys are like just good mates as well, so yeah, it's like great to have a spoke for your good mates. I think Jacob Dawson, someone that really racing with him at Fiji, he was great.
Quite a lot of great guys at Fiji.
obviously James Stanhope would be scraping it, but Mason Durant was true, someone I loved rowing with. He was a big hero of mine when I first started in Newcastle.
Matt Austin?
Yeah, Matt's really good.
How many feel that you picked this brother first?
Yeah.
Cox.
Yeah.
I've had quite a few good Coxes. There's Rory McPhee, who won't be one champ pace with, and a guy called Charles Berry, who won champ pace with.
Our Gram of the Week or Gram of the Month slash whatever it's been, how long it's been. Tim's going to choose our, we picked three Instagrams that we've liked, and Tim's going to choose them, choose his favourite. When you qualify for the final after training only three times together, hashtag Cox Elijah. And it's, he's the biggest guy on the boat, showing some serious swag with a pink headband.
Good night.
Good night. Here's the second one, it's of your pairs partner Tom.
Who's that?
Tom? I don't know who it is.
I've never heard of
him. Capturing ball so hard, what should you order? Leander Gile. Very good. Very good. Punny. And then the last one is How Tall Be Awesome. The mountain, and it's just a snapshot of him and his rig, and it says 200 kilos.
That is also a very good contender.
Yeah. So which one would you choose? I mean, that one's our favourite, the one with the Cox.
It's very close between the Cox one and Leon Vigile.
Yeah.
But probably would go for Tom Boy.
Yeah. Overall, it's a strong 4.3. These men did well.
So, thanks again to all those people who hashtag CoxSingle on all their Instagram pictures. Hashtag CoxSingle, yeah. Tim's going to be hashtagging CoxSingle on all his Instagrams now, so I hope it's going to spread even more. Make sure you hashtag CoxSingle on your Instagram so we can show them next week or the next episode we do. Tim's got a bit of stuff to plug, so if you ever wanted a talk from expert nutritionist Tim, then how do you find it, Tim?
So it's at TimBoSlicy on Twitter and Instagram.
On both, on Twitter and Instagram, yeah. And they can contact you there for anything, really.
Yeah, so I do nutrition talks at clubs and schools.
Yeah.
So I do have a nutrition degree, yes. And I'm studying towards a graduate diploma in IRC. So I'm learning what to make.
You also see you're not wearing a zipped jacket, so you've got rid of that.
No, that's a standard.
Thanks.